Hey everyone, what's going on? Greg here again from TM Blast. In this video, I'm going to go over how you can track your keyword rankings on a daily basis using SEMrush for Google, Google Local, and also Bing Search. Hope you guys enjoy. I'm in the position tracking section within SEMrush. So if you don't know where that is, you want to look on the left-hand side under SEO, go to position tracking. Now, I've already created this for my website, TM Blast, but if you have never done this, simply put in the website you want to track the keywords for. Then where it says the location you want to choose. So you can either do state level, you do city level, you even do country level as well, like United States, if you're a national brand. And then you simply add the keywords you want to track on a daily basis. It's quite simple. So now that you know how to create the keyword ranking report, I want to go over how I use this to my advantage. So this is the landscape view. This is a quick summary overview of how everything is progressing for tmblast.com. I use this for all of my clients as well. Visibility is a KPI that I care about, also estimated traffic too. Where I care most about is using the overview tab, because the overview tabs can give me a lot of insight into how the individual keywords are either improving, staying the same, or decreasing. So again, I'm looking at 30 days. Now, as I scroll through this, I'm gonna point out something for you guys to be aware of. So here's the term New York Local SEO. You're gonna see it says position 8, and then it has a 1 with, it looks like a map icon. That is a local 3-pack map listing. So when you track your keyword, especially on a state level like me, you have this thing over here that says Google 3-pack. Now you can either check it off or keep it blank. So for me, I'm gonna keep it checked off because I wanna know how my local rankings are doing in the map pack. So you can see it went from position 8 to 1. 7 position improvement. You can click on the view SERP. Now it's gonna show me a cached version of how Google has crawled the SERP for that keyword and then where my business is now ranking. So you can see it's in the map pack here. TM Blast at the very top is position 1 for the term New York Local SEO in the state of New York when you search for that. However, though, as you scroll down, these are the traditional listings. Here is my traditional listing here. Now, you might look at this report and say, well, 1 says position 1. What does that mean? So if you go back into this report, you want to actually now check off the Google 3-pack. And that's actually going to refresh the results and remove any of the local map pack from this. So looking at the same keyword again, New York Local SEO went from position 5 to 3. So now 2 different rankings, right? Position 1 and position 3, they both improved, but the SERP is actually a little bit different. So what I mean by that is that you can go into the average position for this. You can see how it went from position 5, now it's position 3. I'm looking at just the individual keyword, and I can click on the cached version of Google SERP. So what I'm looking at now is the same keyword, New York Local SEO. Everything's the same, but it's gonna bypass the map pack, even though I'm ranking number 1 there. And now it's gonna show the listing for me, that's position number 3. So this is actually really important. When you're tracking your keywords on a local basis within Google, track it both from local, map, and also traditional, because you're gonna get a lot of insight into how your local map pack is performing, which is quite valuable for local SEO, and also the traditional listings as well. One thing I also wanna talk about is Bing. So SEMrush, you can track your keywords in Bing. You can also track them. You see, if you click on add new target, you can, Baidu. You can also change it from desktop to mobile as well. But for this example, I just track it from Bing and I track it from just a desktop perspective. So same thing, April 1st through the 30th for Bing. Visibility is a KPI. Now Bing does not share their search volume for their keywords, so just be aware of that. Click on the overview tab. Now it's going to work the exact same way as Google. You can check off the local pack at the very top by having this. So if you scroll down here, these are going to include any map pack listings that are present within Bing. So you can toggle this on and off at the very top. And then same way too, I'm going to click on, let's say, go to local SEO New York, the one from position 26 to position 8. Click on view SERP. This is going to tell me exactly how my my website is ranking for this keyword. This is a Microsoft Bing search results. And here are all the organic listings that are ranking. And then of course you get a map pack, which is actually quite it's a larger map pack than what Google displays. So consider that if that's part of your SEO strategy and how you might want to get into that. And then here's my listing right over here. So anyway, that's it. That's the summary report. You can get pretty good information from doing daily keyword tracking. What I also like to do for my clients is do an average rank position. So what I'll do is I'll take 30 days of data and then do it either on a weekly basis or a monthly basis and say, here's your average rank position over all 30 days. And if we're improving, plus also I like to use this report to see if the progress that we're doing on a particular landing page is working or if there's things that we need to do to improve the rank. Anyway, hope this video was helpful. Let me know if you guys have any questions, and as always, have a good rest of your day.